forever you are gone. I just wanna be with ya. Welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans mon canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yokoso. I hope you're doing fine today. This is another video of me. Before going any further, don't forget to subscribe. I love fashion. I do give fashion advice twice a week, Tuesday and Thursday, 3 p.m. is the time every single week. And don't forget to turn on the notification button just below the video so that you can get notified every time that I have a new video up on live here. So that was pretty much about my blah blah blah. But a kind of way to just like show you how you can style really basic outfits and just have it little bit more stylish in a way, if I could say it like that. I'll have basic pieces in our closet and I think it's just a matter of just adding something, and it doesn't have to be something very expensive or super luxurious. I think it's all about just being smart at combining the pieces, and you know I love it. It's all about that. It's all about like mixing, matching, and it's all about... We're gonna go with 4 outfits that I think I love, and if you want to see the rest, of course keep on watching. Yes. For the first outfit, I think I really wanted to stick to something that everybody, and I would say everybody, owns in his closet, which is a jean. As simple as that. And I feel like it's not easy to have it and to wear it during fall because it's cold, but it's not super cold yet. So you can actually dress it up and dress it down the way you want and just have really different outfits based on just one piece. The first outfit, actually, I'm just gonna show you the jean that I'm gonna style. Of course, it's gonna be like normal, you know. Jean I'm gonna style here today is gonna be little one. Bought it at Zara a couple of, I think, months ago. It's not high-waisted and it's not necessarily super low because that's gonna be problematic at some point. It's the most easy way to just wear it because of the cut. I think this is the kind of jean that would go with most shapes. For the first outfit, it was gonna be something super simple, all about having something casual. First outfit is gonna be with a sweater. As simple as that. And I think to me, a sweater and a jean, it's a matter of just playing and choosing the right sweater for it. It's gonna be this sweater. It's really pink, really bright, and I think it's still fall, so you don't want to start with something super dark either. We're not into the winter yet, so just play with like any warmer colors, the mustard, the pink if you like it, the brown is just like the trendy thing like for this fall. You can see here the sleeves are really big and really wide. It's the perfect basic for it. This pink, it would go really well with most skin tones because it's not super strong, it's pretty pale. Good balance here. Add it with boots, and the boots that I went for was the boots that I showed you last week that I bought from Zara. It's printed ones. Said that I really love these boots because yes, it's like animal prints, but it's subtle. And black. So again, here you have a really nice visual appeal because the rest of the outfit is really no prints at all. And you want, and I say it again, I say that all the time, you want to play with that kind of visual appeal part of it. What's gonna make an outfit just like stand out more? Could be the shoes, it could be accessories, it could be like a simple top. But if you have a blazer with it, for example, and the type of blazer, that's just gonna make the difference. So here for this outfit, it was a simple one, casual, because you got the sweater, you got the jeans, and then you got the boots. And the boots are just what I call the star of the show because they're just gonna bring that kind of stylish, you know. We're gonna see you in the street and you're gonna be like, well, it's not bad. And then we're gonna see the boots and you're gonna be like, damn girl, you rocked it. That's really what I wanted to bring out. And like I said before, you can go with the scarf, you can go with the earrings. We have so many options when it comes to it. Another thing that I like about them is the cut. If you have longer legs, it's gonna be good, but if you have shorter legs, it's not gonna cut your leg the way it's, you're gonna like look even shorter. You need to play with the length here. Everybody can honestly put it off. Like, it's like a sweat, accessories, jean, and a nice pair of boots, pretty much. When it comes to the second outfits now, I'm gonna be with the jeans because, you know, jeans are jeans and everybody loves jeans. Well, I think so. A black turtleneck. Great combination here because it's fall. I want to believe that we all have at least one black turtleneck in our closet. When combining with like something much more interesting, you got your chic right there. turtleneck.
I've had this turtleneck for years, if not centuries or ages. Black turtleneck, like seriously. And I decided to have my pink long suede coat that you all know now, I think, or I believe. Let me tell you about that. And yes, I'm getting dark again, but it's okay. Really pale, so could go really well with almost everybody. I'm trying to just really go basic and general for this video because I think everybody can have it in this closet without having to go to Zara or ASOS or any type of like website to just ruin its bank account like I do almost every single week when I go to Zara. I'm just saying. Third thing, I really, really wanted to add another color. That was my point, because you got a blue pair of jeans, you got a black turtleneck, but to me, when it comes to that kind of combination, yes, it could be good, but it could be boring if you stay like that. I had my big chain golden necklace that you know and saw almost on every single videos for the past couple of weeks. And because you have a black turtleneck, you can't really play with any big accessory. Any statement accessory is gonna be good. The black goes with everything. You can have something silver. You can have something really much more golden. And me, I tend to really like anything much more like golden because I think it suits my skin tone better in a way. It's again here a kind of sophistication. At the same boots that I showed you for my first outfit, I think there's a contrast. And you know me, I love playing with contrast, but it's really good to play with opposite colors. And I'm probably gonna do a video on how you can actually combine really nice colors and how you can really be good at doing it with your own skin tone. So if you want it, just let me know. Something that you can wear to go out with your girlfriends, a night out, a really nice cocktail hour, gonna be good because you're not doing too much but you're still sophisticated. When it comes to like black and gold, I don't know, there's just a wonderful marriage relationship there that I enjoy actually. So the third look, Instagram stories, I actually showed it on Thursday morning because I was so proud of myself. I was like, damn girl, yeah, you did it good, you did it good, yes, you did it good. The black turtleneck, I had my lingerie dress from Zara. I'm probably gonna wear it so much for winter as well. Easy, and when I say easy, it's like super, super, super easy to have. It's gonna be this really wonderful, gorgeous, gorgeous lingerie dress from Zara. What I did here is that having the turtleneck, like I said, it's a basic, something that almost everybody has, especially for fall or winter. I feel like for some people, it's really difficult to see the dress and be like, oh, you know, it's something that you can wear to sleep. But when it comes to just like dressing up, believe me guys, you can pretty much use anything for any purpose. Or just clothing could be like multi-purpose. It's a rich, great chocolate brown. But if you wear it like without anything underneath it, it's gonna look like a lingerie dress real quick and you're not even gonna feel comfortable. Well, I wouldn't feel comfortable because it's gonna be way too open and it's fall. You're not trying to catch any type of cold here. I don't want that for you and I don't want that for me, so I'm just saying. I really love, and I think really love the contrast, but it's not a big contrast. Sexy, sensual vibe, but really edgy. I get to just mix match different styles and that gives something much more different. And to add prints, especially when you have plain colors, dark colors like that, you want to bring something to the table. It's like having a chicken with just salt. It doesn't taste anything to me personally, but you know, we can agree and disagree on it and we can even have a debate on it. I don't mind, but personally, I think it's like, yeah, salty and yeah. To add even more pepper and other spices because I love to spice it up a little bit. Had this really great printed belt. Again, it's not only the buckle is like gold, gives a really nice sophistication vibe to the whole outfit. I was like, yes. Give me the life right there. I was like, my cleavage is my leg. That's it, that's all. I was just like killing it with my leg showing. And I think Thursday was like my best day ever. Shoes, what I had was my black pair of boots that I recently bought from Zara as well. It's this one, a tiny little detail, and it's gold. I'm not gonna repeat myself here. I'm in love with gold. The storyline from that outfit was gold. It's a choice, it's an option, but not everybody is a fan of colors, and I was not a fan of colors myself a couple of years ago. How to play with anything brown, black. Why I like this outfit so much, because it reminds me of my old me, if I could say it. Creme of the creme from this outfit, la creme de la creme, like I would say in French. Coat that I bought from River Island a couple of years ago, but we have the same stylist here again, so everything that I show you, I'm gonna show you like similar items in my description box below as usual. Swan in the black brown family area here, and the coat was black and gold. This sexy outfit and sensual, and I would say more like sensual than sexy, to be honest. When you don't have much boobs like I do, and it's okay, it's totally fine, you have to find other cleavage here. You have to it just, yeah, you have to. So my cleavage is my leg, so that was my, you know, my cleavage here. So it's like I can even add more, like, yes, let's add more. You're not trying to like compete with like a Christmas tree. It's not the point, it's not the life. Yeah, set the limits here. Yeah, add a hat, and I think a hat literally is gonna give you the different vibe. And European, there's a mixture, there's a really nice mix. And something else that you can do even more than that, you can add some sunglasses, but the transparent sunglasses. I think I just went quick around this out. I was like, damn, I can add, you know. Whatever you're gonna do with them and whatever accessories you're gonna add to them, it's not gonna be too much, because it's like so dark, it's like dark shades. Look for the accessories, look for the details, has to be the details, especially if you're dark skin as me. When it comes to the last outfit, the opposite, because we are really staying away from anything dark. Cool, because it's still, it's my style, it's my DNA, it's still me in a way. Striped pants that I bought from Topshop a couple of months ago. These pants! Red stripes, more like red and blue stripes. The stripes last year, and we really had a lot of them. But I feel like this year is more like in the brown shade, it's more like Burberry inspired. Point of this video is to show you how you can combine pieces that you already own, or anything similar to whatever I'm gonna show today. So like my starting point from something, or something bright or something dark, and then I get so much more ideas just based on that outfit. I had that, and I had a white top, turtleneck as well, and it was this one. Oh my god, I'm getting so much darker now. The point is to stay within anything like bright. You want that. I had that, and that was my base. Had my white pair of boots that I bought from Misguided. I think it depends on every person out there. Some people just don't like white boots, and I think it's totally fine as well, but I think it's a really nice piece. Unexpected piece, classy, but a classy with like, she got something there, she got something there, you know what I'm saying? Because I love contrast. I bought it last year during the sales from Zara. Even if it's brown, it's a light brown, but with the silver studs, it reminds you of the white part of the outfit without having to have a monochromatic theme. Believe that even if you have a monochromatic outfit, you still want to add details, because if you just have the monochromatic and you don't have any details, it's still gonna be boring. You have to just clash in order to have something, in order to create the curiosity that people are gonna have, and they just like gonna look at you and be like, oh, okay, it's not just white, there's something. When I have something too classic, I'm gonna look for a way to bring something rock, something different. My roots, it's my roots. A pair of like the pink coat, you can have it as well too, and that's gonna be really chic. It's not even the creme of the creme, this is like the creme of the creme of the creme of the creme, you know. Yeah, you got the idea here. But you can have a pair of sneakers as well, because you know me and sneakers. Buying is a good thing, it's fun when you have the money for it, of course, but if you don't have the means or the financial means for it, you can go in your own closet, and I'm telling you, one piece could be 15 outfits, literally. I really hope you liked it, I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any any questions, if you have any suggestions, or if you have your favorites, of course, let me know. I'm always available. My social media, Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Interested in any free consultation, I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna be available for that. And I hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it. And because it's the end of the week, I'm gonna wish you a really, 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 really nice weekend. Have fun. Enjoy your family, your friends next week for my next video. And until then, I say that all the time. Smile, because it's free and contagious as well. So, yep. Bye. Salut les amis, j'espère que vous avez aimé et j'espère que vous avez adoré ma vidéo. J'ai décidé de venir aujourd'hui avec une manière de réutiliser ou réassocier ses vêtements. Parce que des fois, c'est juste nécessaire d'aller dans son placard, de chercher et de voir ce qu'il y a de disponible et de savoir comment est-ce que vous pouvez associer ça. Et je suis vraiment venue avec 4 tenues très différentes. Il y en a qui peuvent aimer, il y en a qui vont pas aimer. Et ça, je pense que c'est tout à fait correct. Je pense qu'une paire de jeans pour moi, ce n'est pas quelque chose que je mettais autant avant, mais je me suis rendu compte avec le temps qu'on peut associer beaucoup de choses, on peut faire beaucoup de choses avec un jean. On a tous et toutes des silhouettes différentes, une coupe qui vous va. Donc là-dessus, je suis vraiment allée avec une coupe qui, à mon avis, n'est pas une coupe taille haute, mais n'est pas une coupe taille basse. Plus peur des morphologies. Mais encore là, bien évidemment, ça peut pas aller à tout le monde, mais ça irait à la plupart des morphologies. C'est dans un premier temps un sweater, et je dis bien qu'on a la flemme de mettre un sweater, et je vais mettre une paire de jeans, puis ça va être ça, puis voilà. À quel point vous pouvez aller avec quelque chose aussi simple, mais la paire de bottes que je vous ai montré, la paire de bottines que je vous ai montré, est ce qui va ressortir, est ce qui va faire ressortir vos pièces, parce qu'il y a des imprimés. Vont très bien avec les coloris ou bien les tons de couleurs que vous avez déjà. Vous pouvez le combiner avec des imprimés vraiment intéressants, mais pas mal d'imprimés variés aussi. Qui est la paire de jeans, j'ai fait une autre tenue, beaucoup plus classique, beaucoup plus chic. Mon manteau en suédine, rose poudré. Encore là, c'est un ton, c'est une couleur qui irait à la plupart des teints. Ça, j'ai bien évidemment amené le côté, le col roulé. Pièce classique par excellence, quand on pense à l'automne, quand on pense à l'hiver. Ma troisième tenue, c'était ma préférée parce que ça, c'est mon côté edgy, c'est mon côté rock, sexy, sensuel, mais edgy. De robe nuisette que j'ai acheté à Zara. Pour rester dans le côté beaucoup plus sombre, vous pouvez aller avec quelque chose d'imprimé et sombre aussi. Mais le côté doré, le côté bijou en or, ça ramène tout de suite, ça réchauffe. La dernière tenue maintenant, qui était totalement l'opposé du côté beaucoup plus sombre, c'était le côté beaucoup plus clair, beaucoup plus lumineux. Vous avez une sorte de pantalon taille haute cette fois-ci. Une sorte de pantalon à pince, col cheminé j'ai envie de dire, qu'un col roulé. Cette tenue, c'est mon perfecto. J'espère que vous avez aimé, j'espère que vous avez adoré. C'est quoi votre préféré? Puis, comme je dis toujours, je suis toujours disponible sur les réseaux sociaux, Twitter, Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram, où je suis la plus active d'ailleurs. Je vais vous revoir pour ma prochaine vidéo. La semaine prochaine, puis d'ici là, je vais vous faire de gros bisous, je vais vous souhaiter un super beau week-end, amusez-vous, profitez du temps parce que l'hiver, ça va être dégueulasse, surtout au Canada. Je dis ça, je dis rien. Comme je le dis toujours, souriez parce que c'est gratuit et contagieux. Bye.